Donald Garner this morning from Iltani Resources. Donald, good to meet you. Good morning.
Hi, Andrew. Thank you for the interview.
Okay, a newcomer to the ASX, listing end of June. Give us a bit of background, firstly, to Iltani.
I resigned from Red River Resources at the start of 2021, and together with some of my colleagues, we founded Iltani Resources. We pulled together a bunch of projects focused on base metals, copper primarily, and critical raw materials, and we looked to list on the ASX. We were planning to list in 2021, but the issues around Ukraine and the economic difficulties sort of postponed our listing. So we had the opportunity. We bought the Herberton Project for the administrators of RVR, and we came on the board on 30th June this year, raising $5 million. So at listing, we had a market cap of 8, raised 5, and an EV of 3.
And one of these projects, the Orient, you're currently drilling there. Tell us a bit about it.
Yeah, Orient is a large silver lead zinc system with indium and potentially antimony. So we are following up on drilling that was last done in 1988, so 35 years ago. So we've got initial 15-hole program plans. I was up there the weekend. We've drilled 11 holes so far, targeting the vein systems. We're looking for large areas of stock mineralization, bulk targets. So yeah, that's going really well. So we're pleased with that. And while we're drilling in Orient, we're kicking off reconnaissance, mapping and sampling on our other projects up there. And that's where we found this epithermal vein system.
Well, that's right. So at the Boon Moo prospect, also in Queensland, tell us a bit about this epithermal vein system.
So we got our consultant, Rob Cameron, to go out, and basically his remit was to, you know, target areas of historical workings, target areas where there was historical exploration activity. So whilst he was doing this, he came across this epithermal vein system. No one knew it was there, never been mapped, never been sampled. There was no historic workings on it. So he noted it, took one sample, moved on. So during the course of his work, he took 29 samples over the entire area. So, but when the assays came back, the one sample he took from the vein system ran 7.8 grams gold. So that was really exciting for us. So it just so happened that we've got another consultant down at Orient called Nick Tate. He's a really experienced geologist, and his actual area of expertise is epithermal gold deposits. So he was doing some mapping down at Orient. So when we heard of when this assay result came back, we got Nick to go up and have a look. So Nick located the point where the assay sample came from. Then he started work, and he's come back with a report saying we've got an epithermal vein system stretching 600 meters to the north. He only went to the north. He could see it going to the south. He didn't go to the south. And he is really, he came back really, really excited by what he found. He said it's low sulfidation system, and the system is exposed at or near the boiling zone where the gold drops out of the system.
So clearly, you're planning some follow-up mapping and sampling here.
Yeah, so Nick took 13 more samples. So those samples have been dispatched to the assay lab in Townsville. So 4 to 6 weeks to get the results back. We've also applied for the area of ground that was vacant to the north where the vein system is. And we're going to get, we'll be back there doing more mapping and sampling, and just follow the vein, see where it goes, and to the north, to the south, and look around about to see what we can find. The ultimate objective is to understand the grade of the vein, the size and extent of the vein, and set it up as a drilling target. But we've also got a project near Herberton called the Northern Base Metal Project. It's a nice drill-ready base metal target there. We've got some projects in the Rookwood Volcanic Belt near Rockhampton in central Queensland. Plus, we've got an application in the Mount Reid Volcanics in Tassie between the world-class Rosebery and Hellier BHMS deposits. So we've built a really good portfolio. So we'll work our way through our portfolio over the next couple of years.
Well, as you said a bit earlier, came to the market with a market cap of 8, EV 3 million. How would you summarise the investment case here in Iltani?
Look, we know what we've got to do, and we know what our shareholders want. Our shareholders want to see the share price go up. So we are going to... We've got really attractive valuation. We've got cash in the bank. We've got enough to last us for 2 years. We're going to drill our projects, work through our projects, and deliver great drill results. And also, if you imagine, it's like almost like playing a hand of cards. You can only hold so many projects in your portfolio. So we'll work our way through our projects, and we've got the opportunity to bring new projects in to the vehicle to increase the valuation of the vehicle. And when we're talking about new projects, we're looking for copper, because we believe that going forward, copper will be in demand as the world moves to net zero. Copper prices will go up. So if you hold copper projects, you'll make a great return for your shareholders.
Good to see you, Donald. Thanks for your time.
No worries, and thank you.